Hi, lifelong learners. Today we are discussing Rosenhan's battle of the sane and the insane. Do you trust psychologists? How much do they really help people? Meet David. He was a professor of psychology and was concerned about mental health, specifically that the professionals trying to help could not tell the difference between madness and sanity. And if they couldn't tell the difference, then how could they help? David designed an experiment to test how well they could tell the difference between sane and insane. This became known as the famous Rosenhan Experiment. He asked for volunteers and chose 7 people. None of these people had any history of mental illness. These 7 volunteers were sent to 7 different mental hospitals across America. When they arrived, they explained that they had started to hear noises several months ago, and recently the noises changed to voices that said, "It's empty, nothing inside, it's hollow." All of them were admitted to hospital with a diagnosis of either schizophrenia or bipolar. After they were admitted, they reverted to acting normal and asked to be released. They later described the experience as dehumanizing. Nobody talks to you. Nobody has any contact. On average, they only had 6.5 minutes with staff members each day. They also found that behavior that looks normal outside the hospital looked crazy inside the hospital. For instance, the volunteers all took detailed notes of the experiment. To begin with, they hid their note-taking activity, but they soon realized that the staff did not care. The staff that did notice just listed it as writing behavior and attributed it to their mental illness. The only people who did notice something strange were the patients with mental illnesses. They could see that the volunteers were different, that they were not insane. These people were better at diagnosing mental illness than the so-called experts. They said to the volunteers, "What are you doing here? You're not sick. You're not crazy." The volunteers were in hospital, not just for a few minutes or hours, but for days and days before they were allowed to leave. On average, they were there for 19 days. David himself was there for almost 2 months before they allowed him to leave. When the experts discharged the volunteers, they did not pronounce them as cured or sane or healthy, but rather as in remission, that they had schizophrenia in remission. At no stage did any expert realize that this was a test. When David was finally released, he compiled all the notes and wrote a paper entitled "Being Sane in Insane Places." The public loved his work, but the experts were livid. They threatened him and claimed he had tricked them. One large hospital challenged him to send another group of volunteers to them as a test. They were confident that they would be able to diagnose sane versus insane. David agreed to the test. At the end of the time period, the hospital proudly announced that of the 200 people attempting admission, they had identified all 40 of David's volunteers. But David, he hadn't sent anyone to them. They had shown again that they could not accurately diagnose sane versus insane. David returned to teaching and sadly passed away in 2012. But thanks to his work, patient-doctor relationships were improved and they rewrote the whole diagnostic manual. The field of psychology has greatly improved since this experiment. So, how much do you trust psychologists? Comment below. And if you enjoyed this video, give us a thumbs up and subscribe by clicking the button and bell below. Thanks for watching.